In this video, we're going to talk about why the B58 engine responds so well to E85 and what you can do to safely increase your horsepower if you don't have E85 available. Obviously, we have a lot of off-the-shelf maps for E30 mixes that help us get a lot more power with the stock fuel system or small upgrades to the fuel system, but not everybody has E85 available, or people don't want to like deal with the mixes, and so they always ask me what they can do to safely increase the power. And long story short, you have a couple different options. You can either buy ethanol race gas, you can add meth injection, or you can buy a bigger turbo. Those are basically the three ways that you can make more power if you don't have pump E85 available. But I'll go into a little more detail about why it's important and how everything works together. So the first thing to consider is how an engine works, and we'll talk about that briefly, just to make sure everybody's on the same page. So you need three things in your engine to actually make it run. You need air, fuel, and spark. And those three things come together in the combustion chamber, and they do exactly that. They combust, they create an explosion that burns and creates the force to push the piston back down. So I'll try to add like an animation here or something to kind of show what I'm talking about. But as the piston is going up and down, you basically want to catch it so that at the very top of its stroke, the explosion is at its peak and creating the maximum amount of force to push the piston back down. And that rotates the crank, that rotates the drive shaft, that drives everything to rotate your wheels. A big explosion and an efficient explosion is really what you're going for. And that's like, you know, 90% of what you're controlling in engine tuning. You're trying to make sure that that explosion is big, efficient, and safe. So out of those three things, you know, you can modify any of those to create power. For airflow, you know, you can modify your cylinder head, you can get bigger cams, you can get a different intake manifold. But for us with a turbo engine, the easiest thing is to increase the boost, and that creates more airflow, that pushes more air into the combustion chamber to create a bigger explosion. The next thing would be fuel. And you know, you have your high pressure fuel pump all the way at the back, and that drives everything down into these fuel lines that goes into the actual injectors, and that squirts fuel directly into the cylinder so that it can be burned for that explosion. As you increase more air, you also want to increase how much fuel you're flowing. And luckily with our electric engines and everything being controlled by the DME, that's a pretty simple task to increase the fuel flow so that way you can have a safe burn that isn't too lean and can create a good, safe air-fuel mixture. The last thing is ignition, and this is largely where E85 comes into play. So like I said, when you come to the top of that piston stroke, you want the explosion to be at the biggest point of its peak. You want it to be creating the most force. And in order to do that, you actually take the spark plug timing and fire the spark plug while the piston is on its way up. So let's say you have 5 degrees of advanced ignition timing. That means that 5 degrees before the crank is all the way rotated back to zero, and that much before the piston is at the top of its stroke, you're firing the spark plug to start that burn. And it'll burn for that last little bit of rotation to the point where right when the piston is ready to come down, the explosion should be complete at its maximum force to push the piston down as hard as possible. Now, if you advance timing to 10 degrees instead of 5 degrees, you're giving it twice as much time to burn. So you want to basically advance the timing as much as possible, so that way you give it a long time to burn to create a bigger, more powerful explosion, and that can help you create more power. However, if you advance it too much, you can actually complete the burn while the piston is still on its way up, and it'll actually apply force in the opposite direction. You'll apply force to the piston early before it should actually be going on its downward stroke. So you have a limit to how far you can actually advance your timing. The other aspect is what the actual octane refers to. So if you're looking at gas that's like 91 octane, 93 octane, or in like Europe, it's referred to as 95 RON and 98 RON. The actual octane rating refers to how much it resists knock. So you want fuel that will basically go into the chamber, mix with the air, and spark with the spark plug only when the spark plug timing fires. However, when you're actually compressing the air-fuel mixture, it's creating enough heat where, under the worst scenario, it can begin to ignite the mix before the spark plug fires or in a separate location from where the spark plug fires. So now you have the spark plug firing and another pocket where it's actually creating an explosion, and those two can collide. That's what creates engine knock. Our cars on the B58 engine actually have a pretty high compression ratio. So when you're looking at older engines like 10 to 15 years ago with turbos, they were typically like 8 to 1 or 9 to 1 compression ratio. That's because they had to drop the compression so that it wouldn't generate too much heat when you're increasing the boost and adding the turbo boost pressure. You don't want it to create so much heat when the piston compresses the air-fuel mix that it ignites before the spark plug fires, or ignites separately from where the spark plug is firing. Now in modern engines, it's a lot more efficient and it's safer to run higher compression ratios, but that also means that it's even more sensitive to knock if you use low octane fuels. So that's really the gist of why E85 is so important and why it responds so well. Because with a high compression ratio and making sure that your air fuel mix is safe when you're running higher boost pressures, you need high octane to safely increase those and not generate too much heat that creates knock. So now the question is, if you don't have E85 available, what can you do? And I know of three options. One thing a lot of people do is just buy race gas or buy bioethanol. So if you buy like Ignite 98, that's 98% ethanol. You can buy bioethanol. There are a lot of options for that online. If you go to like Summit Racing or eBay, you can find high quality E85. It's actually nice because you know that it's going to be like E90 or E98, whatever it's rated as, versus pump E85 like I get. I have to measure it, make sure that it's, the right quality. Sometimes it's not E85, sometimes it's more like E80 or E75. So that makes it more difficult to calculate mixes. If you spend a little more money and get actual race gas, it'll be higher quality. You'll use less of it to create the right mix, and it'll stretch for a little bit longer, even though, no matter what, it's more expensive. The next option is to add meth injection, and a lot of people don't realize this, but meth actually has a higher octane rating than E85. Both of them are alcohols, but methanol has an even higher octane rating than E85. So if you add meth with 93 octane or 91 octane, it'll give you similar, if not better, results depending on how much you're flowing. The last thing is to upgrade the turbo, and this is something that a lot of people are hesitant to do, or they feel like it's not a viable option, and I'm here to tell you it 100% is. The issue that we have with our stock turbo is it's small. So when you're trying to push, 500 plus wheel horsepower out of it, increasing it to that much boost generates a lot of heat, and that heat goes into the combustion chamber, and then when you're also compressing it to our high compression ratio, it creates a high likelihood of knock. If you run a bigger turbo, like for example, a Pure 800 or a Big Boost kit or a DOCRace kit, you can put that bigger turbo to make the same horsepower at a lower boost pressure and it'll generate less heat. So now you can safely add more power and turn the boost up and make basically the same kind of scenario from like a heat and octane knock resistance perspective, but you'll be making more power because the turbo's more efficient. So, in that case, I highly recommend upgrading your turbo. It makes it the most plug and play. It's really simple. You don't have auxiliary systems like with meth injection. You're not buying really expensive fuels and trying to keep it on hand in your garage, and it'll work all the time. So that's really what I recommend to most people. And I'll have another video talking about turbo upgrades, but I definitely recommend, if you don't have E85 available and you don't want to run meth, just get a bigger turbo and it'll allow you to make more power with low octane fuels. So hopefully that all makes sense. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks.